Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and we're back with some latest space updates for you. We'll begin with SpaceX preparations on launch tower catch arms, followed by missing details from PEA submitted by SpaceX, then we'll discuss how SpaceX became a $100 billion company. We'll wrap up with continued investigation on Starliner. Let's get started with SpaceX teams working on catch arms. Keeping an eye on the orbital flight of Starship, SpaceX teams are working fast on both the vehicle and orbital pad. For the catching part of the orbital launch tower, SpaceX engineers have started work on the two major catch arms and one quick disconnect arm by mid-2021. Then assembly of the quick disconnect arm was finished and installed in the tower by late August. By late September, they'd also attached one claw-shaped structure in the quick disconnect arm. Leaving behind the main quick disconnect equipment, which is yet to be installed, the quick disconnect arm of the tower is more or less complete. This orbital launch tower's main attraction is the catch arms, popularly known as robotic chopsticks, which will catch super heavy boosters and even starships during landing. Assembly of the base structure of catch arms was completed by early August, and by early September they've completed wiring, plumbing, and other necessary works on the catch arms. Recently, SpaceX teams have moved on preparing the arms to get installed in the launch tower as soon as possible. Already, they've lifted the Mechazilla carriage and installed it on a jig-like structure where it will get the catch arms installed on it. Mechazilla carriage is the main connecting structure around the orbital tower, which will hold both the arms in their position and will also make the arms able to go in any direction. According to some reports, just a couple of days after SpaceX teams have lifted off the Mechazilla carriage on the 10th of October, one of the catch arms was also lifted up and was adjusted in the air with the carriage. This effectively serves as a preparatory step for the installation of the catch arms with the carriage. SpaceX have used their largest crane to carry out this process. Report says that the first catch arm, or the right arm, was kept hanging in the air from the crane for a long time, as there were predictions of high winds. As per some reports, SpaceX teams may require another large crane to lift up the second or left catch arm and adjust it also with the Mechazilla carriage too. Once adjusted, a massive steel rod will be passed through the hinges to hold both the arms with the carriage. As soon as this installation is complete, after a few minor works, the carriage will be ready to be installed on the launch tower. Before we move on to the next segment, let's take a look at what our sponsor for this video, NordVPN, is offering to all of you. NordVPN is a highly rated and the fastest VPN service providers in the world. It hides your IP address and present location by encrypting your internet traffic to ensure all your passwords, documents, or sensitive data stored in your personal devices are completely safe. It's top-notch in terms of privacy and security, as they're using a solid military-grade cipher to encrypt your connection, which is routed using only secure tunneling protocols. Their kill switch prevents privacy compromise, and you can boost up the protection with a double VPN. It allows you to connect 6 devices on many platform types. Another big advantage is you can choose any country as your current location and access a series of OTT content which may not be available at your location right now. Just select the country from your dropdown. So get NordVPN right now, as it's available for 73% off, plus 4 months for free. Please check the description below or go to nordvpn.com/engineeringnord to try the service for 30 days. Now let's discuss missing points from documents submitted by SpaceX. Earlier, it was revealed how the environmental document needs the U.S. Federal Aviation Administration approval before SpaceX can begin testing its rockets. Experts say key details about the source of fuel are missing. The Federal Aviation Administration issued the Draft Programmatic Environmental Assessment (PEA) last month for public comment. The document consists of 142 pages and covers details of the construction and other details of the pre-flight operations, launches, landings, rocket tests, fuel and water supplies, and electricity updates. The rockets will consist of a new pre-treatment system for purifying and cooling natural gas. Information about the new PEA is not covered completely, Along with that, there's no clear detail about how more than 10 millions of cubic feet of gas get daily into SpaceX. According to Pat Paterno, professor of law and senior counsel in the Environmental Advocacy Clinic at Vermont Law School, missing such important details is unlikely and might infringe with the Federal National Environmental Policy Act, NEPA. Parento said, NEPA is what we call the look-before-you-leap law. It's designed to inform federal decision-makers about the environmental impacts of their actions and ways to avoid them. Usually, a pipeline gets into work to transport gas to power stations. Certain information suggests that. SpaceX planned to reuse a defunct natural gas pipeline, which is running through the lower Rio Grande Valley National Wildlife Refuge. According to the official and state records, the said pipeline hasn't been used since 2016. SpaceX was planning to dig its own gas and gas wells earlier this year. After facing issues about it, SpaceX wrote, "SpaceX has a unique ability to utilize natural gas with different economic incentives that do not depend on transportation or sale to gas markets." Now, irrespective of the method implied, SpaceX must have disclosed the environmental effects of it. Parento also says, "Methane is a very potent greenhouse gas, and the courts have said, whenever you're proposing a project that involves methane, you have to look all the way back to the wells, at distribution through pipelines, and at the downstream effect where the gas is burned." He also mentions how other equipment like thermal oxidizer, ammonia storage tanks, and gas flare are not included in the PEA. However, all these equipment can affect the environment significantly. FAA says, "The draft assessment was written in compliance with the National Environmental Policy Act and other applicable environmental laws and regulations." The remark was unanswered by SpaceX. Musk, however, responded in a different manner at a recent meeting, "People say a carbon tax would benefit Tesla. I'm like, yeah, but it would hurt SpaceX." Then mentioned how methane ultimately breaks down into carbon dioxide. He also mentioned the dimensions and some details of the gas station. Other than NEPA, the Clean Air Act can also possibly cause trouble, which says how any 250-megawatt power station is a major threat to the environment. After the public comment period will be over, either SpaceX will be allowed to proceed or the company will have to provide a more elaborate environmental impact statement, EIS. SpaceX's future projects are largely in the hands of the FAA now. Now, let's discuss how SpaceX became a $100 billion company. Valuation of Elon Musk's SpaceX hits a magnificent height of $100 billion. Following a share in the previous week, the company achieved this milestone. According to CNBC, investors of SpaceX sold stocks worth up to $755 million. The shares were sold at the rate of $560 per share. This in itself is a rise of 33% from the share value in February, which was at the rate of $410.33 per share. SpaceX was worth $74 billion when checked last time after a fundraising round of February this year. Now with this new achievement, the company has become the world's second most valued private company. The one company yet to be defeated is ByteDance, the Chinese company owning TikTok. Keeping in mind that SpaceX is not a trading company on public platforms, the details of the investors are not revealed. The CNBC report says, "SpaceX has an agreement with new and existing investors to sell up to $755 million in stock from insiders at a $560 share." According to multiple people familiar with the deal, increasing the company's valuation to $100.3 billion. SpaceX is currently undertaking great projects, as we're already aware of the Starship projects and programs like the Starlink and Inspiration 4. The company's current virtues are notable. This new achievement is another significant trophy for SpaceX. We'll end today's space updates with continued investigation of Boeing's Starliner capsule. On the 8th of October, NASA stated that during the investigation, engineers have become able to free up 12 of 13 clogged propellant valves inside the Starliner capsule. Those clogged valves were discovered before the second orbital flight test, OFT, which was scheduled in August, and ultimately led to postponement of the OFT-2 test. According to NASA, one of the valves was kept clogged for direct root cause analysis. They also stated that, according to Boeing, the valves get clogged due to reaction between nitrogen, tetroxide, and moisture. NASA also confirmed that Starliner wouldn't be able to fly in 2021 as the investigation is going on, and NASA has other crew missions also in hand. The agency said, "The team currently is working toward opportunities in the first half of 2022, pending hardware readiness, the rocket manifest, and space station availability." Steve Stitch, NASA Commercial Crew Program Manager, said, "There's really not an opportunity for OFT-2 to fly this year. From a station perspective, it would be sometime early next year where a window would open up for OFT-2. He further stated, "We really need to get to a root cause on the valve issue on the service module. Once we do that, we'll have a little more certainty on the path forward of when OFT-2 is, and then from that, they'll head for crewed flight test." Stitch said in defense of Boeing, "I have every bit of confidence that they're going to figure out what the problem is, and they'll rectify it, and we'll get back to flight really soon." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.